The Detroit label churned out hit after hit with an incredible roster of artists and the killer songs to match. And it was their A&R process that was responsible. Sugar and spice. Sugar and spice. Everything nice. It was the brainchild of car factory worker Berry Gordy, who had the vision to take what he called quality black music to the whole of America.
Berry was the first person to critique us. He would tell us what was good and what was not. We were trained. We knew exactly what we needed to do and say for our audiences.
Their A&R system really was competition. You know, you got to come up with the goods. So that was like an amazing A&R sort of like factory.
While Berry Gordy was clearly the driving force behind Motown, his right-hand man helping pick those hits was his head of A&R, Mickey Stevenson. Mickey met Berry for the first time in 1959.
My idea was to get with him and become an artist produced by Berry Gordy. His idea was to have me become the A&R man for his company. But so we were on two different planes when we met. So I pulled out about six or seven of my kind of wannabe songs, right? And I sang them, and he said, wait a minute, hold on. I didn't call you here to be a recording artist. I said, what do you mean? I thought you liked my songs. He said, your songs are pretty good, but your voice is for shit. He said, well, I want you to be the A&R man for my company. I said, A&R, what's that? He said, you're going to handle the artists, and we're going to make records.
Mickey's first job was to search for talent. In the early 1960s, he began holding regular auditions at Motown HQ.
People were there every day, lined up, hoping to just get a chance to get in the building. Everybody wanted to be a part of this new record company in Detroit on the Boulevard. I never met a girl who makes me feel the way that you do. You're all right.
Whenever I'm asked who makes my dream real, I say... The A&R process became like a musical finishing school, paying close attention to every aspect of the artist's act.
Singing is one thing, performing is another. The choreographer, they would show them how to move, what to do with their hands, how to make that look good.
We had rules and standards. We were not ever scantily dressed. We were always in uniform. We had someone who always traveled with us to make sure that we were on time and dressed properly. We were learning music theory. We were learning choreography from Charlie Atkins. And we were getting social graces being taught to us by Professor Maxine Powell. Ladies, you don't dance with your buttocks. You use your feet, and the body will follow.
My theory was this. If you have a record and you don't look right presenting it, it dies quick. You don't have to have such a great record, but you look good doing it, it's taking off. Now, if the record is good and you look good doing it, it's going all the way.
Key to Motown's success was Mickey's ability to match the right song with the right artist. Dancing in the Street would become one of the label's biggest hits. Written by Mickey, Marvin Gaye, and Ivy Joe, the writing team had originally promised the song to Motown star Kim Weston, Mickey's wife at the time.
It's a fun song, and Kim has this strong voice, so we got to have some joy in it. So I'll get somebody to sing it, and then she'll copy that, listen to that track, and repeat it. And who? And I said, got just a person.
Mickey fetched aspiring singer Martha Reeves, who by then was working as his secretary.
So I asked him, could I sing it the way I felt it? And he said, sure, go ahead. It was the same key that Marvin was singing in. So I piped in, calling out around the world.
She sang the tune. Marvin looked at me. Ivy Joe looked at Marvin. We standing looking at each other. Did you hear that? That's a hit record on Martha. When you hear something like that happen, as an A&R man, that's what it's really all about. I mean, that was like, wow, that marriage was perfect.
Mickey had some explaining to do to his wife.
Of course, I had to talk Kim out of it. Not talk her out of it, but kind of figure out how to get it away from her to give it to Martha, because we were lovers.
Kim and I almost had a take off your earrings and get your Vaseline and scratch each other's eyes out fit. We almost had that.
Of course, my love was cut off dead after that. Oh, that was cold for a while, brother. Everything was cut off. I couldn't even get a kiss.
Motown showed the music business that having the whole package makes a successful star. The look, the moves, and the sound. But it's also about finding the right song for the right artist.